All right, so next I'm going to use Zoom. A lot of folks already have Zoom installed on their machine. So new meeting, and now I'm going to invite Chris here. All right, so now Chris is in. There he is. Whoa, multiple cameras, Chris. Can you hear me?
I can't hear you, actually.
Oh, I'm muted. there's another thing you got to make sure you're not muted. All right, so in Zoom, again, you have a built-in recording ability. We're going to click that. So feel free to use this, especially if your guest doesn't have the ability to record audio locally. Sometimes going through all that explanation is just too much work. So feel free to use the built-in recording if that's all you have. It's better to get the audio than not have it. But if you can convince both parties, especially if you have a regular co-host, to record locally as well, once you start recording in Zoom, head over to QuickTime or any other recording tool you have on your computer. New audio recording, select the right microphone, quality high, and I'm going to start recording this here. Generally, if your guest already has Zoom, you'll probably want to use Zoom. The other advantage with Zoom is you'll be able to record the video as well and chop that up into different clips for promotional purposes to put on YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook. So it has kind of a dual purpose. You can record both at the same time, which is pretty cool. So I'm going to hit stop on here and stop in QuickTime. And again, I would export both of these, and in this case, I would send them to over to Chris at Lemon Productions.